My recent videos have covered big picture revision. And while revising a scene isn't often as overwhelming as revising a whole book, it does have its challenges. Scenes are the building blocks of your story. And if a foundational scene is too weak, your whole story collapses. So today I want to share 5 steps to effectively revise your scenes. These 5 revision steps will ensure your scenes are strong and impactful. This is Ignited Ink Writing, a channel dedicated to helping writers like you transform your writing so it lingers with your readers. Because writing that lingers gets remembered and recommended to others. I'm Caitlin Burvey, editor and writer. Step 1 is your scene's purpose. Every scene needs to serve a purpose for your story. It should either advance your plot or deepen your characters, or both. If a scene is not doing this, you probably need to cut it. If you don't want to cut it or feel it needs to stay, then you need to either add a purpose, make it deepen a character or advance the plot, or you need to combine it with another scene that is already serving a purpose. Scenes that don't serve a purpose slow your pace too much and often feel tangential. These are the things that bore readers, that they skim or skip altogether. Once you've identified your scene's purpose, you want to draw that aspect out even more. Ask yourself, how is it advancing the plot? How is it deepening my characters? And how can I bring that more to the surface? Step 2 is your scene's description. There are 3 main types of description you need to look at this stage. First, look at how you're describing your setting. Make sure, 1, you are doing that so it's clear to your readers where your characters are. Then make sure you're describing the right aspects of your setting. Your readers don't care about every little detail of your character's home. They only care about the aspects that are going to impact your story. So make sure you're describing in detail the parts of your setting that matter and leave the rest to your reader's imagination. Your readers should be able to picture your setting without feeling like you put the story on pause to describe it to them. This means describing your setting often works better when it's weaved into that whole scene instead of shoved in one large chunk. The second aspect of description you want to look at is your characters. Can your readers picture them? Have you described them both physically and emotionally? Early in your book, you're going to need to do more physical description than later. Later in your book, focus on aspects that have changed or important descriptions that are going to affect the story. And each scene should describe how your character is feeling in response to the events that are happening. This could be you showing their thoughts, or it could be describing an action that the character is performing that's revealing how they are feeling. The third description you want to make sure you have is a description of the events. What's happening? Is it chaotic or tranquil? The event should be clear. It should also be clear where your characters are in this event. We call this choreography. How are they moving about in this scene? How did they get from the corner to sitting next to the other character? Make sure your descriptions are clear, consistent, and concise. Step 3 is your scene's dialogue. If you have 2 characters present in a scene, they should be communicating. This can be verbal or nonverbal. But either way, they need to be interacting with one another. Through dialogue, your readers learn your characters' personalities, their motivations, and their emotional state. The plot is advanced when a secret is revealed, a lie is told, or a plan is made. All of this happens in dialogue. Dialogue needs to deepen your characters and advance the plot, just like all the other aspects of your scene. So add dialogue whenever you have 2 characters in a room together. When you're revising dialogue you already had, look for lines you can cut. Often writers' first drafts of dialogue too closely mimic the way we actually hold conversations. Readers don't want to read, "Hey, how are you? I'm good, how are you?" Skip that part of the conversation. Get right to the meat. Another type of dialogue you want to cut is when the characters are talking more to the reader than to each other. 2 characters who experienced the same event last summer aren't going to talk about it in excruciating detail because they were both there. They already know that. They're talking about that event so the reader knows. This feels unnatural and really is just an info dump. Also, heighten what isn't being said. In every conversation, each character wants something. They have a goal for the end of that conversation. Bring that out. Let the reader sense what they want. Often, we reveal more by what we don't say than what we do say. Step 4 is your scene's mood and tone. In addition to a purpose, your scene needs an emotion. Part of this emotion comes from what happens in your characters. The other part comes from mood and tone. Tone is the way a writer approaches the subject or story they are writing. How a writer describes an elderly woman's purse being stolen determines whether that scene is funny or serious. So ask yourself what emotion you want that scene to have. Then choose words and descriptions that match that emotion. Is your scene supposed to make your reader feel angry? Is it supposed to be tragic or happy? Mood is the emotional atmosphere of your story. This is created by how the setting is described, the way the characters speak, and the tone you're writing with. When you describe a river as glistening in golden sunlight, that's a different emotion than when you say the river appeared to be on fire. Both of these are saying light was reflected off the river, but they're conveying very different moods, very different emotions. Step 5 is your scene's pace. Many aspects of your book contribute to the pace. Everything from the spacing that you choose to use to your word choice is going to affect pace. To control the pace of your scene, control how many words you're using and what's happening in that scene. If you want to make a scene feel fast-paced, like an action scene, use shorter sentences and shorter words, and only describe the details that are directly impacting that moment. Leave the other details to a later scene. If you want to slow the pace in a given scene, spend more time on descriptions, use longer words and longer sentences. You can include more detail here. When you're deciding what pace a scene should have, think about where it falls in your story. If you just finished a really intense scene, maybe you want to draw the scene out, slow the pace, to give your readers a breather. If the opposite is true, you just had a slower paced scene, maybe you want to follow that up with a faster paced one that gets their heart beating and keeps them turning the pages. I'd like to leave you with why a developmental editor recommends these 5 scene revising steps. Each scene is unique, so you'll likely have to look at other aspects as well as these 5 steps. However, this is a good starting place. I recommend doing these 5 steps in this order because it forces you to look at the bigger picture of the scene first and get that in order before you start quibbling with word choice. When you are bringing out the purpose of your scene, you're likely going to cut and expand certain sections. So you don't want to find the perfect word for the tone of that scene when that sentence might end up being cut. Revising scenes is one of my favorite parts of revision, because I can see the effects immediately. Unlike a big picture edit where I have to do a change here and there to smooth out that character arc, when I finish revising a scene, I feel like I've completed something. How do you approach revising your scenes? Share your process in the comments below. And for more videos on revision and other aspects of writing, subscribe to Ignited Ink Writing, a channel dedicated to helping authors like you transform your writing so it lingers with your readers. Because writing that lingers gets remembered and recommended to others. I'm Caitlin Burvey, editor and writer. To find out more about me, go to www.ignitedinkwriting.com. There you will also find a revision checklist, which will walk you through big picture edits, scene level edits, and line edits. And now it's your turn to revise your scene's purpose, description, dialogue, mood, tone, and pace to ignite your ink.